Let's give it a round of applause. From Buccaneers to Galaxy Royalty, these adventurers come ready to rock our Disney World. We have our first contestant coming out, and this is Erica and Julie, the Curse of the Red Moon. Up, we've got Alec Crow, Flynn Rider, everybody. All right.
He did all that leather work, you guys. That green vest is actually distressed and is real leather.
Very, oh, it's got the frying pan. Good, good. Yeah, but keep it low. Yeah, keep it low. All right. Awesome. Next up, Tahira Agbamuchi is Shuri from Black Panther. That was confidence right there, and it was out there, and it was like, and I got the first. All right. Here we go. Adrian Chu, Elizabeth Swan.
What you guys need to know about this outfit is that she did hand stitching throughout. So all these little ties and everything is just authentic to the time and hand stitched.
Very nice. Next up we have Velma Ripstein, and she is Merida, warrior princess from Brave.
Staff or the thing, the bow was not even wood, you guys, and we saw it up close and it looked like wood. She did an amazing job.
And at first, I thought Bette Midler was here when she came out. She's here, you know. No.
That's three for
you. That's three. That's right, three.
I'm keeping score.
The only thing Yvette felt her to dream is keeping my score. Like, you're out by category
nothing
three.
Nothing on my page. I'm just keeping score on him.
All right. All right, Davidson Sim, Light Cycle Power Run, Disneyland Shanghai. Wow.
It's your Uber.
Here we go, my ride's here. It's my Uber. Let's go. Very nice. Wow. Now that's a costume. That's a costume and a vehicle all in one. That's what I love. All right, Connor Breen, Bad Egg. Be careful.
She's late for his tea party.
And the thing that you don't know is that was just somebody out on the show floor that he just picked up. Like, I need you for a second. All right. And next up, we have got Alexandra Wright, She's Captain Marvel. Yes.
Higher, further, faster, baby. Hand-painted Fonz lunchbox with a Tesseract that was almost stolen in the 1970s, but I thwarted it. Sort of.
See, look how much you know now.
She hand sewed that entire uniform, you guys. Come on, come on.
Next up, we've got Todd Robbins. Groot takes on the universe. Thank you. All right. Next up, we've got Catherine Aguiar. We want the redhead. And just a simple rope belt sets that whole outfit off. Exactly. All right, next up, Juliana Leacon, Rafiki. Beautiful. Get right out here at the front of Pride Rock, yeah. All righty, Ben, I'm going to call you on that. That's a point.
That's a point for me.
Oh, Rafiki.
You guys, I enjoy judging this so much. You don't even know. It's so much fun. I'm glad you're here.
All right, Brianna Joseph, Tale as Old as Time in a Galaxy Far, Far Away. Rapunzel. She's got the moves for that character. That's the character. Yeah. Very nice. Next up, we have got David Collins, Force Spirit of Obi-Wan Kenobi. In case of emergency, watch for David and he will show you to the exits. Justine Pond is next, and our last contestant in this category, Kakamora. Wow. There we go. I get a point back. Very
just
nice.
Just getting a point back. You got a point back.
And just a simple pair of pedal pushers. I love that. There you go. go. All right, we're going to have you stay right out here because that is the last part, that's the last person in our category. So you come right out here, talk front. There you go. Right over here, let's bring all of our contestants out. And as they come out, let's give them a big round of applause. Not great. It's like my family reunion in Michigan. No, Aunt Ruth.
Aunt Ruth for your Uber.
What's that? Oh, my Uber's here. Yeah, here we go. All right, so what I would like to do once again is, to anybody want to tell us something about their costume that we may not know?
Favorite part of my costume because it is in fact curtain fabric from one of the Disney hotels. There's hidden Mickeys all throughout the fabric. It's right there. See, it's right there. There's another one right here. And then it goes over to another one right over here.
All right. Okay. Somewhere at the Disneyland Hotel, somebody's dressing in front of the window and going, oh my God, where are the curtains? All right. But the curtains match the drapes and we're happy. Good. Are you okay, first of all? I want to make sure. All right, you don't have to take any of that. All right. All right, judges, did you enjoy this category?
Loved this category. I'm obsessed, well, with all of them.
Yes.
But I have, like, Wakanda fever right now.
I have a little Wakanda fever.
Yeah.
That and Rafiki.
I think the whole world does, actually.
You know, listen, this category had a lot of people that did a lot of detailed work.
Yes.
Anytime I grab this mic while someone's out here, to let you know that no matter what you're looking at, it took a lot of time to see, and you guys can't tell from out there how hard they worked on stitching and leather work and all that kind of stuff. So I tried to give you your flowers while you were up here. And hand sculpting. Rafika hand sculpting of that little mask that Rafiki has.
And remember, if she likes it, she'll say, turn around and show your butt.
Yeah, if I like it, I ask to see your butt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, at first I was offended when you said that to me, and then I was like, okay.
She likes me.
All right. Any other? Yes.
Yeah, so actually, speaking of the details, I mean, let's see, Erica here with the pirate, there's Cheerios on it, literally.
Cheerios.
It's like part of its
well, there were.
There were.
I know.
You did get hungry earlier. He had a few.
Oh,
right off the
Cheerio detail. Oh, and it's all yarn at the end. Those are all, the whole headdress is all like pom-poms and yarn that she created. It's, listen guys, they worked really hard.
And the thing that I was struck with, because this was, Worlds of Adventure. When you guys were coming out, the likeness that you had to the characters was amazing. Because not only are you talented building things, you're actors too. And that was really fun to see. Anybody else want to say anything about their okay, yes, here we go. Look at you. Anyways.
I just want to say I am not a mashup. I am a canon outfit from Rapunzel's Tangled Adventure. So I am not a mashup.
And nobody ever call her a mashup. I mean it. Oh, thanks, Sophie. Rue. Yes, I'm sorry. Your bark is always worse than your bite. I know. Yeah. Oh. Here we go. Are we ready? Are we ready? Front and center. Sophie, get down here with me. We are going to reveal our winner of our category. And for Worlds of Adventure, Jason, give us a drum roll, please. It's Tahira as Shuri. All right, let's give them all a round of applause as they exit the stage. Thank you all. Hard work.
7 of them to win.
Like, this is literally heartbreaking for us.
It is. I'm still upset about Up not getting going further. He wrecked me. I mean, he walked into the table and wrecked me. I literally, a little single glory tear like Denzel just went right down.
Yvette made him recreate. You made him recreate the first 4 minutes of the movie.
I did. I literally had him go through the whole. No, I didn't. But his costume just like was the whole. I can't. All right. Everyone's great.
And if you're loving the costumes up here, all these guys are out on the show floor. So see them. If you see them go up, tell them congratulations. Say how much you love their costume. And they're going to be down in center stage this afternoon where we can celebrate them again. Ready for category number 3? Yeah. We got more. This is my favorite category because this is heroes and villains. Good and evil. All of that classic struggle to life to Disney fashion. And we are going to start with, get this name, Necessarily. That's the name, not the costume. Ursula the Sea Witch. Sorry to the sound people, I'm sorry. Just like, they're like, what? I can't hear. All right, yeah. If any, that was amazing, man. Can you imagine trying to get in a cab with that on? All right, next up, we've got Jenna Lang, Darth Vader and Maleficent mashup. We did not know about Darth Vader.
Okay, but the leather work on her costume is absolutely incredible.
It is. It's beautiful. Yeah. All right. Clap for leather. Always clap for leather. You learn one thing at D23 Expo. You clap for leather. Unless it's warm out. All right. Here we go. Henry Wilkinson. Queen Ursula is the fight of the Ursulas. Girl, you are mad.
Jim,
I got hit by a pentacle. I'm okay. You think in the morning when you wake up that you're going to be hit by a tentacle. That's it. It was what? She was mad.
She was very upset.
She was very upset. I almost want to get some tartar sauce.
Tartar sauce out here. You just gained a point back. Now you're at 1.
All right. Next up, we have got Casey Potter along with Zach Potter. This is Blue Fairy and Honest John.
I didn't believe. A night is life for me. A nice and handsome ring. A bunch of gold with a diamond chain. I'm gonna be gay. A night is life for me. Which thing for me is a liberty. A night is life for me.
Beautiful. On the affair, you know, it's Honest John with just a touch of Chewbacca, I think. Just beautiful. Yeah. Minnie DeMuchis here, Lady Tremaine. Beautiful. It's on your mind, Lady Tremaine.
Ungrateful
sewing work on this piece, you guys. Seen it up close. She's very, very classy lady.
This. Here. All right, next up, we have got Char Star, Ursula the Sea Witch. It's the Battle of the Ursulas. Gorgeous. More hair than all of Milwaukee on that head. Beautiful. The commitment of that hairspray alone. The commitment of that hairspray. And I understand, none of them are getting along backstage either, that's what I hear. None of them. All right, we have got Sarah Misser, Hannah Alexander, let me go ahead and start that again. Sarah Misserve, along with Jennifer Glinzak. They are Hannah Alexander, Rapunzel, and Sunset Dragon Mother Gothel.
Mother knows best. Take it from your mumsy. On your own, you won't survive. Sloppy, underdressed, immature, clumsy, please. They'll eat you up alive.
Wow! Man. Very nice. Never trust Mother Gothel. Never trust Mother Gothel.
I love a transforming.
Beautiful.
Transformation.
That's how I get ready in the morning.
Yeah,
I
just shake it off.
I shake it off. I'm like, you're right. All right, here we go. Is there a baby here? I'm old. Sometimes I just hear babies. Okay, all right. Next up, we got Catherine Omer, Dragon Maleficent. Control that with my eyes.
Artistry.
It's a costume, it's a show, it's an attraction.
So that's actually a mogo from a drill, I think.
It's is it really?
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yes.
I would have said windshield wipers, but yeah.
What?
Windshield wipers too. Can you imagine if we had one? Yeah. It would have been very chicken. Alrighty, we have got Judy DeMars, Rococo, Queen of Hearts. This is beautiful. Look at that.
This is another one where the sewing artistry is like, you can't even see from where you guys are sitting, but there's so much attention to detail in this costume. Kudos to you.
There you go. You know when the fan goes up and out, she's done. Done. Garrett Engel, up next, I put a spell on you, an ode to Winifred Sanderson.
I put a spell on you.
That book was handmade, and it feels like flesh.
It does.
It was handmade because it was made from a hand. That's what it was.
Jim lost
it
all.
Can you give
lost
it.
It's a Lee press on.
It's okay.
It's okay.
But she might need it later for the
girl. But in mail. Here you go. Oh. Don't you hate when you're ready to go out and you lose a nail and you're like, crap! I love her. You know, with braces, she'd be great. All right. Here we go. We have got Jennifer Penfield, Steampunk Ursula, and Ariel.
Under the sea.
Is that right? Handphone?
This is so hard, you guys.
Only one can go forward, and you see what we're dealing with here. My God.
All right. And great showmanship out here today. This is a show. All right. Dominique Wood, Fantasy, Fireless, Maleficent Dragon. Very beautiful. Beautiful green eyes. Tail, no fire because of OSHA. Thank you. All right. And Jonathan Swindle, Captain Jack Sparrow. Backstage water. All right, that was our last of the category. Let's bring all of our contestants back out. Villains and heroes. Heroes and villains. No Ursulas next to each other. Because it's just going to get ugly.
Just listen to teacher. I know it sounds salty.
We had a lot of Ursulas, but there's one in particular that I don't know if you guys saw that her tentacles move and it freaked
totally
the crap out of us
out
on the table. Did you make a move?
Her what?
Her tentacles move on their own.
Right there.
Do you see that, you guys? You see it moving?
Get hit by another tentacle.
I know.
It's, right there.
They move like little snakes on their own. I don't know if you guys can see
it's
that.
It's not on my health plan.
I just like good artistry. I wanted to give her a shout out.
Here we go. Oh. All right. We're going to keep moving down to each side. We've got to get all the Ursulas out here, and you do not want to make this one mad. All right. There we go. Here we are. All right. So now, in all of their villainous and heroism, let's give them a round of applause right now. Every color in the entire spectrum is represented on this stage right now. All right, so I want to hear some stories from folks who want to say anything about their costumes, because we've been, yes.
Cinderella shouldn't have the only good shoes.
No, those are nice shoes. Very nice. DSW, $12.99. All right, what else? Anyone else? Yeah, sorry. Hocus Pocus.
I'm waiting for my sequel, Mr. Disney.
And somehow I think he can hear you.
Don't worry about your makeup.
Bette Midler, I hear you're here today.
Anything? Oh, girl, she's here today, right here. Okay, all right. What else? Anyone else? Oh, here we are. Is it you, Jack?
It is I. So. This is weird. Most of my effects that I am on my person at the moment got off of a dead drunk.
All right. It's one of those moments, All right, Lou Fairy.
I was told if I didn't do this, I'd be in a lot of trouble. So shout out to Miss Potter's second hour class. I miss you, I love you, and be nice to your sub.
many kids?
I teach about 210 kids, but 37 in my second hour.
All right. The teachers, the unsung heroes of our community, let me tell you. All right. We've got those tabulations going. I don't know if you know this in the back. We've got an abacus that we use, and we just, like, it takes a while, but we're going to get all those tabulations all done. Anyone else want to
Here
tell a
go,
quick story? Yeah.
I also teach first grade.
Of course you do.
Yes. No.
She's the swimming coach. Yes, yes. Again, Sophie, you guys. All right, so heroes and villains. We can only have one winner in each category. They're all winners to us. But our winner, and Jason, another round of applause. Nissa Sarah Lee, Ursula. All on your train. It's beautiful. Thank you guys all so much. You were awesome. Thank you very much. Let's give them a round of applause. Jack, you know where you're going, right? Marriott, lobby bar. Yo.
I'll be back. I'm going to have a drink with Jack here. This is amazing.
One thing I want to point out before we get into the next category, can you imagine how difficult it would be to play hundreds of music cues all in one show? This man knows how right here. DJ extraordinaire, Disney events for many, many years. He is awesome. All right. No Ursulas near each other. Here we go. It's like the 405. There we go. There we go. Okay, Jack. All right. It's awkward. Just awkward. Drunk. 11 in the morning. Let's give him his own attraction. I don't see an attraction for us. Oh, you've got an attraction.
What?
Alice, you've got your own attraction over at Disney.
Oh, yes.
Ashley, yes, I do, of course.
I thought you were talking about Ahsoka. I'm like, wait, when?
Jen, how are you doing down there? You hanging in there?
Jen, how do you feel?
Doing great.
She's doing an amazing job. She's very nervous.
Yeah, give her some applause, you guys.
Rock, rock.
Jen!
You know what I'd like to hear in a sentence? Entrepreneur and president.
Come on!
Just happened.
Boss!
All right. Category 4. And you look fabulous down there in the end, by the way. Category 4. Our next category is inspired by Disney, so let me make sure you understand what that means. Animation to cruise ships to live action film, anything Disney, this category brings out the unique in creativity. And we're going to start with Tina Elliott. She's returning again this year. I remember from last year, Grim Grinning Gown. Stop it. Okay. The doom buggies are moving.
You guys, they turn at different intervals just like the frickin' ride.
This is scene by scene, the Haunted Mansion.
It's the exact order that you take the ride is happening on her dress. There's hidden Mickeys.
Watch this. And we've got dancers in the ballroom dancing.
Moving.
Mind blown.
She said she started to conceptualize this the day after the last D23. This is 2 years in the making.
As soon as you get in the back, we're going to put a wall around you and put you down for refurbishment because we have to get you ready for the holidays. Yeah. All right. Wonderful. Thank you. Our next person is his name is what I say when I burn myself. Vito Pache, Disney-inspired pirate. Wow. You guys, let's sit out here at the edge and watch the electrical parade. Look at that.
Amazing.
He's also vacuuming. Yeah, which is great.
Okay, you know what? You just gained another point.
If I could be zero by the end.
Yeah, you're at zero now. All
right. What you guys aren't seeing is that the pirate on the back talks.
And the cannons shoot real smoke.
And in just a minute, I'm going to press a button. He's going to go 72 miles an hour. 1-0, it's going to come back. Yeah? There you go. It's amazing what you can do with just an old Zamboni.
Oh yeah, it was 4 years in the making, this one.
4 years?
4 years in the making.
Wow. When they said it was back, they said it was back. All right.
You guys knew what was happening with this scoring up here. There's a lot happening with
this right.
story.
Next up, we've got Nora Chapkovich.
So hard.
Haunted Mansion, Bat Stanchion. A stanchion has come to life.
Gotta see the boots.
Can you do that?
Gotta see the little birdie boots.
Yes. Those actually look like my feet.
You would rock those boots.
I would.
So good. Short.
It's very
good.
Nice.
So good.
This is so hard.
Wow.
And it really looks like that skin.
It. I hope it wasn't. Yeah, the Bat Stanchion at Haunted Mansion. Yeah, the little figures that go right on the top of the stanchion. Who knew? What a great idea for a costume. Thanks,
very original.
Nora. Grace Duval. Kitty! Here to perform Shallow. Sully never had a chance. Sully should be a duvet. No. There's only one eye in Mike. All right, beautiful. Beautiful. Sully didn't feel a thing, kids. Don't even worry. Fawn Quinn, It's a Small World After All. Oh, just kidding. Oh, next one?
Sorry.
Okay. Christine Marchese is Haunted Couture.
I got no strings to hold me down, to make me red, or make me brown.
Amazing. You gotta show our hitchhiking ghost back here.
We have two haunted mansions, yes, but they each are done in their own unique, beautiful way, with attention to detail in different ways. This is what makes the judging so hard.
And thank you, Haunted Mansion, for having a 50th anniversary. This has been great.
Jim, was her hat actually stretching? Because her hat moves.
Her hat was stretching.
Her hat stretches.
All right, I am going down to Harmony Leaker.
Jim, I have a question, Jim.
Yeah.
That was Christine, yes? So Fawn is gone? Okay.
Next up, we have Harmony Leaker, Stromboli's Marionette Theater, or SMT.
noticed that? Attention to detail.
It got really dark during the end.
Yeah,
it was great to be. Anytime you could part your skirt and puppets come out, yay! That's what I say.
We just lost a point.
Lost a point. But she can ride in the carpool lane. That's the thing I'm happy about. All right. Sierra Rivera de Cordova, children of the world.
Wonderful.
It's a small world, you guys. Hand sewn. All that beading. And there's music coming out of her corset. Like when you, I mean, it was though. Like Small World plays from her bosom.
You know what? There's no better aphrodisiac.
You just lost another point.
No, that is beautiful, beautiful. And my cat would play for days on her head, let me tell you. All right, Kristen Hopkins, The Apprentice's Broomstick. Oh.
Are handmade. That is not a wood bucket. She made those, guys.
Yeah, she just lost a point right there.
Yeah.
She just lost a point.
Talk anybody about it. All right. Good. Do not tell her about the vacuum cleaner. It'll just depress her. All right. Joey Monaco, the cat box ghost.
No one is quicker than a bad dog cat. Every nook and cranny and dog beach cat. When he's on his rounds, nothing's outbounds to his curiosity. He can smile at a pretty girl till she don't want
to. Comes with a simple cocktail purse. Beautiful. Oh, I want a rolling table when I walk around. Just do. All right, next up we have got Garrett Smith, everybody. Cruella Incorporated.
Cruella, Cruella.
That's right. She's in the boardroom now, ladies and gentlemen. She means business. Yeah. Once again, Sully has fallen to prey. Oh.
The calves are real.
Is that a euphemism? Those shoes. You know, Zach, you would look good in those shoes. You would.
He looks amazing in them, though.
He does. All right. Elise Filipek, the cutting edge, everything you want and more.
Life worth living. Just
for giving.
You just stay
for giving. Sewing machine, a telephone, a computer. Oh, look, a lamp, a radio with speakers, a gumball machine, and a vacuum. Oh, the vacuum.
Who loves the brave little
everything
toaster?
You need.
Right? It's so good.
All right. All right, she is last in our category. We're going to bring her right over here. Everything you want and more, by all means. There you are. You look great. We're going to bring all of our contestants out. Oh, perfect. The broom next to the vacuum. Yep. All right, here we go. All right. This is what I like. An attraction that comes to you. You don't have to go and get in line. Go.
Wanted to come on out. Who was I to tell them no?
You know, you keep them, you let them come out. Here we go. Here we are. Let's give them a round of applause. inspired by Disney in all new interpretations. All right. 1 second. Yeah, I told you those shoes would not work. No, here we go. Here comes the Bat Stanchion in the Haunted Mansion. There we are. Keep going, keep going. It's just like, can I sleep over at your house? I'll bring all the bedding. Yeah.
I want to wrap myself up in that coat so bad.
All right, there you are. So I am going to get up here. First of all, tell us something. You look like you have something to say.
I got monsters in my closet, darling.
You've been with Jack Sparrow, haven't you? Okay. All right, we've got two attractions next to each other. These are amazing. The detail, the movement, the colors, awesome. I think we... This is Haunted Mansion, 50th anniversary right here. That's the mansion. What would you like to say about your costume?
It's out of our hands.
I love it. And you not only were you wearing a costume, you were doing puppetry.
Oh, of course. I mean, you gotta, if you're going to have a puppet show, you got to do a puppet show.
And then you got dark, because you're strong bully.
Well, you know, come and see the puppet show. Bring money.
And then later, you just... wooden shavings. Yeah, you don't know. All right. This is beautiful. How many beads are here?
55,000 sequins. All hand sewed on, they're all loose sequins.
Are you kidding? There's really 55,000 sequins? Isn't that many in the world? My gosh. Not anymore. All right. And when did you start working on this?
I started working on this costume 3 years ago.
Wow. Judges, anything you want to add to this lineup of beauty?
This was, for me, the hardest category to judge. And I think if you guys look at the artistry up here, you understand why. One person is going to move on, but I'm telling you, five or six of you could have went on. Five or six of you could be best in show. I need you to understand that. So when you walk off the stage, don't think if it's not you, it's not because you did not do what you could have been for it to be you. So understand that.
All right.
Talent.
Sophie is here with some news. Yeah. All right. Jason, give us a drum roll. Oh, Sophie, I'm sorry. Can you hold that for just a second?
I appreciate the crowd, but I'll take care of the sound effects here. Thank you.
All right. Here we go. And our winner of Inspired by Disney, Tina Elliott, grinning down. Here. Very nice. Let's give them all a round of applause. Thank you. From afar. All right, thank you all. We will have you exit the stage. Give you that quick 20 minutes to do that.
I'm telling you, this one broke my heart. This one, I'm gutted with this one. And this is taking nothing from Tina and her artistry, but I'm telling you guys, if you guys could see up close how much these people did, this one hurt.
We would have just picked the whole category. Everyone would have won.
We picked every single one that was up here in that category. They were, oh my God. You guys can't even see how, okay, I'm done.
But it's good. It's a lot of detail. Final category.
Oh.
The category of cast of characters. This is where we can have more than two people up here to bring these costumes to life. I may use a name. That's the person that submitted the costume, but there may be others obviously helping them out. So our first one in cast of characters is Skylar Barrett, Stained Glass Enchantress and Rose. Mm.
Was custom painted, you guys, to look like stained glass. So this isn't fabric. She painted this to look like stained glass.
Candy.
right. Adria Sanchez Chedez, Crepe de Porte. Show. I love this. All right. Thank you very
gorgeous.
Much. Next up, submitted by Natalie Lawson, Disneyland's world famous Jungle Cruise. Along with Natalie is Ken Hazlett, Amanda Dunn, Michaela Sullivan, Lydia DuPont, Andrea Seal, and Rukenza Di Benedetto and Joanne Dragon.
Water! Make it real, water! Make it real! Serve it, water! Make it real, water! We're on a jungle cruise, everybody!
She knows her way around a river, let me tell you. All right, next up we've got Jennifer Ackley, the Pixar Princesses.
A dream is a wish your heart makes when you're fast asleep. And dreams will lose your heartache whenever you wish for you.
Things. I don't know
how did you know where that landed? It was behind your head.
You narrowly escaped. Injury there. All right, Catherine Rainier, Mad Princess Party. Elizabeth Lee, Familia de Miguel from Coco.
Remember me.
Oh, she's got the chancla out. Feathers for days.
The attention to detail on this group of cosplay is just amazing.
Beautiful. Thanks, guys.
Beautiful, you guys.
Next up, we've got Rachel Kosick, Kingdom Hearts inspired Beauty and the Beast.
Hello.
rocks off. That's how I want to remember them. Elizabeth Todd, the Femme Fatales, along with Amber Hunt, Ashley Hill, Prue Dents, and Samantha Kitts.
And they are the male villains from each movie turned into females. Femme Fatale.
Right.
Trendy. I love it.
They look good.
But I'm told, yes.
Carla Robertson, along with Jackie Ledoux and Shannon Reagan, Flora, Fauna, and Merriweather.
And if I know you,
they could have stayed out a little longer.
They're beautiful.
I enjoyed it.
They left, just like that.
They just went away.
We didn't ask them to leave, they just left.
Me too.
There's probably another show starting downstairs. Joseph Queen, the family and frenemies of Thor Ragnarok. It's like being at the Pantages.
Jim, are you okay back there?
What?
I was worried about you.
I know. They all look at me like they want to harm me. And I don't understand that. All right. Up next, we've got Charlotte Kriska, Once Upon a Dream. And then it got dark. All right. Next up, we've got Rachel Elston Roth, Snow White, and Princess
someday,
Ernie.
Someday.
To her papa who passed away, so we're so happy to have her here. And a little bit of him is with her here today as well.
Beautiful. The detail on that skirt is amazing. All right, Emily and Nathan Mebust, the deity Mara and the gigantic cobra Fluffy from Indiana Jones Temple of the Forbidden Eye. All of our contestants. Now, what we're going to do, because there were more people in that section than in my hometown, we are going to have a representative from each of the groups come out and flank the stage. Let's give them a round of applause. All right. Best of show and walks away with a cool $2,300. Here we are. All right. Beautiful. Our cast of characters, let's give them a big round of applause here. Each representing a different group. All right. And so now I'm going to walk around. Anybody want anything? Anybody got anything to say? Tell us about your costume. Tell us about the process.
Yes. Hot like fire. Yes. Like water.
Yep. That's what I say. All right. What else? What else? Yeah.
I broke on stage because I'm clumsy, but each of our wands glows in each of our colors. So pink, blue, and green.
Well, and you're kind of you were angry at the beginning when you came out, so yeah. Aww. Don't worry, we'll talk later. Don't worry. All right, what else?
Remember me.
I've got your picture at home, right on the mantle. Don't you worry. All right, judges, anything you want to say about this category? Because this is a performance piece.
You know, I will say the performance really played a factor.
Yep.
It did.
Great. And not only... Yeah, I agree. I don't know what else to say. I mean, it did. And there was choreographed teacups. There were flying fairies. There was an actual battle on stage. There was all sorts of things that happened. There's a lot that happened.
We had it all.
If this carpet could talk... You know.
Yeah. And then the idea that these are the leaders of each of these groups, so these are the people that either that designed and did most of the work for. If you saw 12 people up here, one person was responsible for the look of that group. So just know that each of these people were responsible for a lot of people looking great up here.
Yeah. And I'm curious. Exactly. I'm curious. You guys were the leaders. You kind of got the entry in. How did you cast the rest of your group? Was it easy? Was it hard? Are these friends? Are these people you just coerced into this? How did this happen?
Anyone ridiculous enough to join us? Pretty much. Yeah.
It's fun. And you guys will be here the rest of the day, walking around the show floor. Yes. Performing. I hope. Yes. All right, we are waiting on tabulations, and let me tell you what we're gonna do is we're gonna find out who wins the category cast of characters, then we're gonna bring the other four category winners, I know, the other four category winners, it's your baby, Jason, we brought the baby, it's right over here. And we are gonna bring all four of those out, and then we will find who gets best in show at the 2019 D23 Expo Mousecarade. Oh, here we are. And here we go, and this is the winner of Cast of Characters, drumroll Jason. And the winner is Catherine. Catherine, where's Catherine? Catherine Reglier. There you are, the teacup. Are you happy? You know what I think I would do if I were you? I would get out there and you spin that cup. You spin that cup. Let's bring... Okay, there we are. We have seven clapping teacups in the back. They're going to... I think they're back there cheering you on. Let's say thank you to all of our friends here. Thank you guys very much. We'll have you exit.
My favorite part is you got happy in like half a cup.
I know. It was, yeah, just half a cup, because sometimes you don't need a full cup. You know, it depends on the recipe. Yeah. Here, let's put that down for you. Okay, so I think what we're gonna do, and I gotta check, are we gonna bring your other friends out so they can all be out on stage, because they all helped you win. Are they, is that happening or not? Yep. Yep, it is happening. Yep.
Vamp, Jim, vamp.
Yeah. Oh, there's Sophie with something. There you go. All right. What?
What?
Sophie does get best in show in our backstage contest. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So what we've got here is we're going to bring out our other category winners. Let's see. If you remember back, once upon a costume, we have Alan, who is Lumiere. Let's bring him out. Right over here, Alan. In Worlds of Adventure, we had Tahira from Black Panther. Shuri. Very nice. All right, in Heroes and Villains, we had Vanessa, who was Ursula the Sea Witch. Don't do that again, because that'll put someone's eye out. Right there. And we have our cat, and then we also have inspired by Disney, Tina Elliott, Grim Grinning Gown. Here she comes. These are our five category winners. Bring the house down with your thunderous applause. Wow. Wow. You have to. You have to. Let's do it. All right. Here we go. How's everybody feeling?
Very heavy.
Okay. So, what was the inspiration? No, I'm kidding. No, that's all right. And how are you feeling?
Shaky.
Yeah, be careful with that. Okay. You look fierce. I love it. And how are you feeling?
Well, my legs are still shaking.
Okay. They are. My gosh. All right.
My flame is about to be extinguished in anticipation.
Call me. Yeah. All right. And?
I am so happy right now.
And your friends are back there cheering you on. So that is awesome. All right. There can only be one best in show. There can be only one person who we hand over $2,300. And they become the best in show for D23 Expo 2019. Only one person can do it, and they're going to be on the center stage to be celebrated by all of the show later, and that is none other than Jason. Tina Elliott, Grim Grinning Gown. All of you are all winners today. Wow.
Can I say something? If you guys get a chance to see this on the floor, I want you to see the detail, because I don't know if out there you can see what this really is. So I need you to find her on the floor if she can still carry 60 pounds of this, and just take a look at what she created. And all of you were amazing.
And she will be on center stage later. And by the way, I have a fast pass for this later. All right. So, congratulations. We want to say thank you very much. How does it feel?
Amazing. I'm so excited.
If you're sitting out there and you were inspired by what you saw up here, get in line for our next Mousecarade. We want to thank all of you. We want to thank you for being at D23 Expo. Come see us at center stage about 1 o'clock, 1:30. We'll be celebrating out there. Thank you and have a great expo. Thank you, judges.
Mousecarade, presented by Raw Threads. Please join us later today at the D23 Expo Street Party on Mickey Avenue and at Center Stage as we celebrate and congratulate all of our contest winners.
Yeah.
countdown for three. Three, two, one.
D23 Expo 2019.
One more time, guys.
Oh, what?
That was perfect.
That wasn't it. Oh, trash.
So perfect, we're doing it again.
Wait, can the cameraman be in this one?
There we go. All right, guys, one more time. Here we go. One more time. Three, two.
Effort for me.
Never mind. All right, guys, here we go. Looking right up here. Here we go. Three, two, one, looking up here. Awesome. I'm good. We're good.
All right. Thank you, everybody.